Most Americans now agree that Donald Trump's administration's response to the pandemic has been, well, I guess a nice word would be lackluster. Most people are not happy with the job the president has done. They do not believe he has taken the issue very seriously. And there's a good reason that they think this. First and foremost, we can see his performance every day in those daily press briefings. And ironically, it wasn't until he started doing those daily press briefings that his approval of the handling of the situation actually started to go down. Like back when the public wasn't hearing him every day, they actually thought he was doing a good job, but now they know better. But every day we're finding out a little bit more about how horrible the response from this administration has been. Like yesterday, when the story came out that in the early days of the pandemic, Alex Azar from the Department of Health and Human Services actually put a former labradoodle breeder in charge of the pandemic response. This was a man by the name of Brian Harrison, who came to the Trump administration, Health and Human Services to be specific, after 6 years of being a professional Australian labradoodle breeder. And some time ago, he became Azar's chief of staff. The man has no experience in public health. He had no real experience even working in a bureaucracy. Again, man spent the previous 6 years breeding dogs. And in fact, according to the reports, many members of the Trump administration derisively referred to this man as, quote, the dog breeder. So this was well known within the Trump administration. They knew where this guy came from. And I'm not trying to sit here and just, you know, crap on this guy. But he was put in charge of the response. As the reports indicate, all of the reporting on this, you know, the whole chain of command, everything went through him in the early days of this. Everything, they said, through this former dog breeder. That's who we had in charge. That's why things didn't happen the way they should have happened. And then obviously the reports go on to explain just how horrible Harrison was because he had no idea what he was doing. For one, he didn't loop in the FDA. He didn't make the FDA a part of their little task force. Didn't make the head of the FDA a part of their task force and their response panel. So the FDA was left in the dark. And I'm sorry, but at this point in time, that is one agency that you definitely need to have on your side. They're the ones who need to know where we stand with possible cures, where we're at with testing. They're the ones that need to be working with these pharmaceutical companies to do necessary testing to make sure any potential vaccines are safe and to get them rolled out and approved as quickly as possible. But Harrison, you know, didn't think that was necessary. So here's the problem. And I don't even blame Mr. Harrison for this. It's not necessarily his fault. It is the fault, one, of Alex Azar, who straight up is the guy who put him in charge. But two, Alex Azar himself is a former drug industry guy. I mean, that's where his money came from. That's where his livelihood is, the drug industry. He has no business even being in this administration, so the fault of that rests solely with Donald Trump. When you have incompetence at the highest level, they're always going to pick people who are as equally incompetent or more so than them to run the government. And that's what we have right now. It all flows from the top. You have reality show host, drug industry insider, dog breeder. That was essentially the chain of command in the early days for the pandemic response. Reality show host at the top, drug industry insider, and number three was a dog breeder. So if you're wondering how we as a country let things get so bad with the pandemic, I think that little three-step scenario there is probably the only thing you need to know.